The erosional or degradational landforms related to glaciers that I want you to know come down to these four. Here's what they are. The first one is a cirque. This is a bowl-shaped basin, shaped like a bowl, like a cereal bowl or a soup bowl. And it's formed at the top, or what's known as the head, of the glacial valley, so way up in the tops of the mountains. Arêtes, which are saw-toothed peaks that are formed between glacial valleys, so they make these very sharp-edged ridges between glacial valleys. They kind of look like a serrated knife. The U-shaped valley or U-shaped trough or glacial trough, it goes by a lot of different names. This is the primary glacial valley. It was formerly a V-shaped river valley, but through plucking and abrasion, the glacier has hollowed this V-shaped valley out into a big U-shaped valley. And hanging valleys. These are formed where tributary glaciers enter the main glacial trough, in other words, the main U-shaped valley. And they usually create a cliff above the valley floor, and in many cases they have waterfalls that go over the top of them. So if this is a pre-glacial landscape, you could see V-shaped river valleys before the temperatures cooled off. Once the temperatures cool off in the area and enough snow can accumulate to begin to make glaciers, the landscape switches to something like this. Of course, this is theoretical, it's a diagram. There are a number of features here. You can see I circled two of them, the cirques and the arêtes, which are those sawtooth peaks, the cirque being the bowl-shaped basin that's formed at the top of the glacial valley. But there's a number of places there where cirques are being formed and a number of places where you can see arêtes. This is just pointing out a couple of them. Now, what we have mostly on the planet today, of course, is a post-glacial landscape after the glaciers are gone. So we have to kind of put back together what was there. And if you look, I've circled some of these things. You can see where I circled the cirques, okay? And there's a number of cirques there. A tarn, so here's a tarn, that's the lake that's formed in a cirque. Arêtes, you can see the sawtooth peaks. Hanging valleys, so obviously there's a glacier at where the hanging valleys are at, and it dropped down into the main glacial trough, which is that big main U-shaped glacial valley. Okay, take a look. Here's a real photograph. You can see the cirque, which is that bowl-shaped basin that's formed at the top of the glacial valley. There's a little bit of glacier still left in that cirque. The arêtes, which are those sharp sawtooth ridges, those peaks, they look like a serrated knife, that are formed between glacial valleys. This is a tarn. A tarn is a lake that's formed in a cirque. As you can guess, if you have a bowl-shaped basin, the glacier disappears through ablation, melting, evaporation, sublimation. Because you have this bowl, when more precipitation comes down, the bowl can fill up with water, making a lake. That lake that's formed in a cirque is known as a tarn. This is Lake Solitude, which is up in the Teton Range. Remember, we met the Teton Range when I was talking about normal faults in the tectonics lab. This is Yosemite Valley, the classic U-shaped valley or U-shaped trough. Take a look here. You can see that U. Look at that. Look at that. Because that had 3,000 feet of glacial ice going through it at one point. A hanging valley. So over on the right-hand side, this is Bridal Veil Falls, which is also in Yosemite Valley. What happens is that comes off of a hanging valley and drops into the main U-shaped trough, which is Yosemite Valley. You can see that's where Bridal Veil Falls is at. That's the hanging valley, that U-shape that's dropping into that much larger U-shape. And you can see now I've highlighted these things. You can see the hanging valley, which is the yellow, dropping into the main U-shaped trough that is Yosemite Valley.